Good morning, class 12. So I have done the first part of chapter 8, where we discussed all the case studies. So to summarize what we have done in the last chapter of section C, the first part of your chapter discusses case studies. So we have done the case study on the Amazonian forest and its depletion, and we also discussed mitigation measures. Then the second part was the case study on ivory trafficking in Africa. I have told you about that. The last study was on the depletion of the ozone layer. So after this, a very important topic that you need to understand and learn is globalization. So on page number 148, you have a topic called globalization, and you need to know what are the pros and cons. Globalization mean? The whole world is today called a global village. Village is a place where everybody knows each other and the people are very closely knit to each other. A small place. Similarly, the world today has become a global village, meaning that the interaction between countries has become very, very easy. Communication between countries, interaction, change of currencies, trade, import and export other countries, bringing cultural exchanges from other countries. The way the world is integrated today, that is because of the developing trade. This is called globalization. It's very easy for people to communicate and travel to other countries, from other countries, and also to export your country's products to other countries. So what is globalization? Globalization means the interaction between countries. How do we interact? There are various forms of interaction. Either there is import and export, so you are very friendly to other countries because of your trade relations, culture, there is exchange of currency. Lot of communication like this has been taking place between and this process is called globalization. Now, when we say globalization and our communication with either the underdeveloped, the developing, or the very developed nations, our communication has improved. This particular improvement in communication and interaction, they again come with some positive effects and some negative effects. So we will try to understand what is the positive effect that globalization brought about, and we will also see the negative effects of globalization, right? So the first part of your chapter, this particular topic, discusses how countries integrate or tie up with each other, right? So there are two types of integration. This is an objective question. What are the types of integration in globalization? There are two types of integration in globalization. One is positive integration and the second one is negative integration. Now I will first tell you about negative interaction between countries. When do we call the interaction between countries negative? Is when we break trade barriers. That means we do not follow the laws when we practice free trade. There is no barrier, there is no quotas involved. When one country can freely trade with the other country without any barrier, without following any quotas, that is called negative integration. Because when there is free trade between countries, it is seen to bring a lot of destruction to the environment of the countries. And the positive integration is when the laws are very strictly put in place by the countries. Exporting and importing products from other countries, and your law is in when you are following the laws of your country, you are not allowing each and every commodity to flow into your country, neither are you allowing your country's industries to suffer. That is called positive integration. So negative integration is when we do not follow the laws and when there is no trade barrier involved. Whereas positive integration is when we are strictly following the laws that have been laid down in your country. This is the first part of globalization. Globalization means integration of countries, and integration is of two types, that is positive and negative. Okay, then now we will try to understand at least 5 to 6 advantages of globalization. What are the positive effects when I am very friendly to another country? I am exporting and importing products from other countries. What is the benefit that it has brought to your country? So the first point says, with globalization, there is global market for companies to trade their product. So we have Indian industries who are not only distributing their products within the country's boundaries, but our products are getting a chance to go to other countries. So as a consumer, how am I benefited with globalization is that products in front of me. A small product I want to buy, I have my own country's products plus the products which have come from other countries. So as a consumer, I am benefited because I have a host of products in front of me, and depending upon my financial suitability, I can select my product. So this is one benefit that countries have got, is that we have millions and millions of products to choose. So trade market has increased. Then developing countries benefit a lot because there is flow of money. Other countries' finances are flowing into your country. So economically, definitely we are progressing because the GDP of your country rises with globalization. The gross domestic product, the gross national product, both GDP and GNP of your country, they rise when there is a lot of trade with other countries. Then the third point says, to meet that follow globalization, there is increase in the production. So now, once if your country's products are demanded and liked by other countries, what will happen within the country is that the production by the industries will start increasing. So more the production by your Indian industries, more is the economy that comes into your country. So we have seen a significant rise in the production sector by the industries because of the global market that we have been able to capture, right? Then competition. We have our own Indian products, plus we have products coming from other countries. So as a consumer, I will definitely choose a product which is lowly priced. If the price is low and the product is good in quality, consumers will definitely go into buying products which are much lesser in price. So what is happening is there is a lot of healthy competition, and that competition has kept the prices of commodities low. Nobody will increase the price so much that consumers don't buy and then your products cannot be traded, right? So what has happened is, because of the global market, because of the competition that has arisen, everybody is trying to keep the prices low. And then the next advantage is that communication among the countries is on the rise. I have lots of trading partners, so I will definitely not spoil my relation with those countries from whom I am getting the commodities and to whom I am selling my products. So because the communication between countries has risen, there is a very friendly relation and there is lesser chance of disturbance, that is war. So the more trading partners you have, With globalization, the lesser is the chance of terrorism and war, right? And as communication between countries increases, what is happening is there is interchange of culture. You must have heard that cultural exchanges between countries, our country's culture goes to, there are cultural dances and cultural songs which go to other countries. Similarly, there is cultural exchange from other countries as well. So these are a host of advantages that we have seen with rising globalization. Now again, we need to understand the next part, that is, what is the negative effect that globalization has brought about. So I will tell you a few points on the negative aspect of globalization. So page number 149, the first point talks of workers. Let's take a very simple example of our own country. The labors in our country, their labors are very, very cheap. India is known for cheap labors. So what is happening? A developed country, the same labor is paid very high, whereas a developing country labor like India is satisfied with low income. What happened because of globalization is that the Indian workforce, that is the Indian laborers, they are demanded by the other countries. So a developed country will pool the laborers from India to their country. Why? Because for the same work, they will pay the Indian workers very less amount of money as compared to a labor in their own country. What is the disadvantage we see here is that developing countries, on one hand, they are losing their labor force because they are traveling to other countries. And what is the negative effect in the developed country? The labors that the developed countries had, they are losing their job because the developed countries have all higher labors from the developing countries. So we have seen a significant portion of labors losing their job in the developed countries because the entire labor force is being pooled from the developing nations. This is one very big disadvantage that globalization has brought about. Next. Companies are opening their counterparts in other countries, like I have already told you about multinational corporations in India. All MNCs, they have their headquarters actually in the developed countries, but they have set up their subsidiary units, that is their branches, in the developing nations. The result is transferring the quality of the product to other countries, thereby increasing the chances of depreciation in terms of quality. So like we have the Coke, the Pepsi company in India, they are not Indian companies, but they are foreign companies. The headquarters is in Switzerland, but we have these subsidiary units in India too, right? So what happens is they do not properly tell you the methods of making. So what happens is when subsidiary branches are set up in the developing countries, most of the time the quality of the original quality of the product goes down because the methods of making the product is not shared by the developed countries. So in one line, it means any product we talk of, when subsidiary units are set up in developing countries, there is depreciation in terms of. Then there is threat that the corporates, that is the larger companies, will rule the world. With globalization, there is so much of demand for industrial goods that if we take the example of India, the small handicraft industries that we have, cottage industries that we have, they are not demanded. What is handmade in your country is not demanded because it is expensive as compared to a product which is made in the industry. Industrial products are always very, very cheap. Whereas, so what is happening with globalization is that there is this poor society, for example, the Indian artisans, the handicraft workers, they are suffering a lot because their products are not being demanded. And then one very big disadvantage of globalization that we have seen is when people travel, the traveling has become so easy from one country to another, communication has become so easy, technological advantages are there, but when people commute like this, there is a lot of spread of communicable diseases. I don't need to explain this to you. You have already seen. One virus has destroyed the entire world, and this is because of, this is a communicable disease, it's because of people traveling from one country to another. This need not be explained to you because we are suffering for the past 8 months with this kind of communicable disease. This is also an effect of globalization. So where one side globalization has brought a lot of good things to countries, on the other side, these are the disadvantages we are facing because of globalization, right? So this is about globalization, what is the meaning of free trade and barriers, I will be discussing with you in the next class. Thank you, class.